there's a ton of math involved when it comes to gardening? While you might be able to think of area and perimeter when you plan your garden, there's a ton more math that goes into the products that you use. Today, we get to go behind the scenes and actually see how the products you use to make your garden thrive are created. Let's get into it.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too, it's all here for you.
My name is Abby Prickett. I'm a process and formulations engineer. We work with a whole bunch of engineers, chemists, biologists to develop home, lawn, and garden products.
How do you use math?
We use math all the time. When you buy a fertilizer product or a potting soil, for example, a lot of work went into that bag or bottle before you even got it. So we don't just mix a whole bunch of materials together and hope it turns out right.
My name's Ezekiel Carl. I'm a chemical analyst for the Scotts Miracle-Gro company. I'm the guy that takes the bag and makes sure that everything that's supposed to be in the bag is in the bag. Typically in a bag of fertilizer, you would have a nitrogen component, potassium component, a number of products to be carriers for a pesticide that we would spray on it, something that would help to kill weeds you didn't want in your lawn or bugs that could get in.
We use majorly grams, pounds for our measurements. A big one that we use all the time is a gallon of water. It's a common watering can size. So we often put like 1 gallon of product, once you mix it, covers 10 square feet, for example. If your garden is 30 square feet, you need to know how much of that product you're gonna use at a single time and then throughout the season to be able to understand how much that you need to buy.
Do you use fractions?
So we use fractions all the time, whether you're talking about a quarter of a tablespoon or a quarter of a teaspoon. Being able to convert between fractions and decimals is also really key.
With our standards, we're looking at something, say, like a 97% concentration. Well, 97% of that sample would be pure, and we can use that to tell how much pure substance is in our fertilizers or our pesticides. To very precise standards, ensuring that you have correct decimal points is important to make sure that you get the final correct result.
What type of tools do you use?
Here at Scotts, we use everything from simple components like beakers and flasks, graduated cylinders that have graduation marks in milliliters, to pipettes, which we use to transfer small amounts of liquids down to the microliters.
To measure actual things, we use balances and scales all the time to do weight.
What does a typical day look like in your career?
My day starts with getting into the office. I'll usually try to get out to our lab space. I'll weigh up each raw material, mix them together, whatever product I'm making, and then label and bottle it up.
I will already know basically what samples I will be testing. I will take those samples, break them down into a smaller sample that I can get a better look at. We'll then take that sample and we'll extract the component that we're looking for.
Why is it important to show your thinking?
I write everything out. Not only is it important that the work that we do is repeatable, if I just mix a whole bunch of stuff together in the lab, not only am I not going to be able to recreate that ever again, but nobody else can either.
Almost all of the work I do here at Scotts gets reviewed. If we see that we have issues with an analysis, I can go back and double check my math and have someone else double check my math.
Did you enjoy math growing up?
I loved math growing up. Just the fact that you can do calculations for really anything throughout your day, because you can use it for so many different things.
Once I saw how math could be used to analyze the world around us, then that was much more intriguing than numbers on a page. It's not something that you can avoid, you embrace it. And as an adult, I have really embraced math.
To feed your plants with fertilizer, you need to mix the fertilizer with 1 gallon of water for every 10 square feet of flowers and vegetables. Your garden is 200 square feet. How many gallons of water will you need? The answer is 20 gallons. I did 200 divided by 10 equals 20. 20 gallons is your answer.
One thing that I like about working here is that it is a lot of one team mentality. Lots of ways to continue kind of carrying the torch for a product even after like my piece of it is done.
I really enjoyed being in a lab. The more time I spent in the lab, the more I realized I would like to work in a lab for the rest of my life. I started here at Scotts and I got to use all of the science that I just learned in school. I've really enjoyed all the different types of science that we do here at Scotts. All of those people working together to do science is a lot of fun. My name is Ezekiel Carl.
My name's Abby Prickett.
And this is How It's Math.
Want more information about how math is used in the real world? Make sure you check out our website, www.doodleslearning.com. Bye!